We are taking R.D. Sharma Solution, Class 10 Maths, Chapter 12, Exercise 12.1. And this is Applications of Geometry, Height and Distances. The shadow of a tower when the angle of elevation of the sun is 45 degrees is found to be 10 meters longer when it is at 60 degrees. Find the height of the tower. So the question is that you can take on other side or same side. It totally depends on you. So the shadow of tower and the angle of elevation of the sun. So this is sun and this is tower. Now the shadow of a tower from when the angle of elevation is 45 degree so one angle is this one and one angle is this one. So which one will be less? 45 degree. And this is found to be 10 meter larger. So this is 10 meter larger. This distance is 10 meter larger than it was 60 degree. Find the height of the tower. So let it be h. If this is 10, we can take it as x. Now I'm taking first the rather this should be like this. Okay. So we have a triangle like this. This is 45 degree. This is 60 degree. This is 10 and this is x and this is h. So I'm taking first the bigger triangle. Why? Because 10 45 is 1. So 10 45 is what? It is going to be equal to 10 45 will be equal to h by this whole 10 plus x, 10 plus x. And we know that 10 45 is 1. So we get 10 plus x equal to h. We'll use it. This implies 1. First equation. Now we'll use the second triangle. This triangle. Here 10 45 or 10 60. Is equal to h by x. 1060 is root 3. So root 3 equal to h by x. So what do you get? H equal to root 3x. And we have to find out the height of the tower. So we are going to eliminate x. So we'll put x as h minus 10 here from this equation. So h root 3 will put x as h minus 10. What do we get? H equal to root 3h minus root 3 into 10 or 10 root 3. Let us bring this one here and this one here. So we get 10 root 3 equal to root 3 h minus h. Take h outside. Root 3 minus 1 is 10 root 3. Now bring this down. H will be equal to 10 root 3 by root 3 minus 1. So we can't leave this root in the denominator. So we multiply root 3 plus 1 and root 3 plus 1 numerator and denominator. So we get 10 root 3 into root 3. That is 10 into 3, 30 plus 10 root 3. And what do you get? Let it be like this. First we'll cancel it, then we'll solve. Root 3 minus 1, root 3 plus 1. So root 3 minus 1, root 3 plus 1 is a square minus b square. Root 3 square is 3 minus 1. So we get 2. So what do we have? 10 root 3, root 3 plus 1 by 2. This is 2, 5. 5 is a 10. So what do you get? 5 root 3, root 3 plus 1. Now multiply root 3 inside. 5. Root 3 into root 3 is 3 and this is root 3. This is your solution. This is your height. This is your height. If you want, root 3 can be taken as 1.732 and you can find out the answer in the decimal form also. A parachute is descending vertically and makes an angle of elevation 45 degree and 60 degree at two observing stations 100 meter apart from each other on the left side of himself. Find the maximum height from which he falls and the distance of point where he falls on the ground from the just observant point. So here we have the parachute. It is at a height of h. There are two points, 1, 2, and one is at 60 degree, one is at 45 degree. That is the angle of elevation from this point is 45 degree, from this point is 60 degree, and they are 100 meter apart. So this is 100 meter. So let us take the height as h from the ground above up, and x is the distance of the first point from the just below point of B. So this is x and this is h and this is 100. So as I said, we have already done this type of question in the previous question. So what we will do, we will take 10 45 first. 10 45 will be what? I am taking this triangle A, B and C. So 10 45 is perpendicular, that is h by base, 100 plus x. We know that 10 45 is 1, so h will be equal to 100 plus x. This is our first equation. Coming to this second triangle, this triangle, that is BDC, we have tan 60 degree is perpendicular by base h by x. What is tan 60? Tan 60 is root 3. We get h. H as root 3 x. Or you can say x, we can take as root this h by root 3, right? X is h by root 3. Now put it here in the first equation. This second equation has to be put here. So h plus h is equal to 100 plus x is h by root 3. Right? Bring it here. H minus h by root 3. So we'll take, I'm taking the left hand side. Take h outside. It will be 1 minus 1 by root 3. So what do we get? Root 3 minus 1 by root 3. So h into root 3 minus 1 by root 3 equal to 100. Now take this up and take this down. So this will be root 3 by root 3 minus 1. Right? We get 100 by root 3 minus 1. But we have to rationalize it. We can't keep root 3 minus 1 in the denominator. So we'll multiply root 3 plus 1 in the numerator and denominator. So here we get root 3 whole square minus 1. That is, we'll get 2 in the denominator. So 2 is the denominator. Root 3 plus 1 remain here. 2 50s are. So 50 root 3 plus 1 is the answer. You can take root 3 as 1.732 and you can get the answer like this in the decimal form. On the same side of a tower, two objects are located. When observed from the top of the tower, their angles of depression are 45 degrees and 60 degrees. If the angle of the height of the tower is 150 meters, find the distance between the objects. So here we have a tower, and if you see that when we have an angle of depression, that means we see downwards. So when it is seen downwards, it is 45 degrees. So this angle also will be 45 degrees because of the alternate angle between the two parallel lines of the transversal. And this 60 degree, this will also be 60 degree because of the, again, same reasoning. This is 150. We have to find the distance. This x has to be found out. So let us take this as y, this BD as y and DC as x, and AB is of course 150. So what we are going to do is we are going to eliminate this y because we have to find x and 150 is already given. So let us take the first triangle, that is ABC, bigger triangle. So triangle ABC gives us tan 45 degree is perpendicular by base. So 150 by y plus x. And tan 45 is 1, so we get y plus x as 150. This is our first equation. Coming to second equation, 60 degree. So we are taking now triangle ABD. Triangle ABD. Tan 60 is perpendicular by base. 150 by y. So as I said, we have to eliminate this y. So tan 45 is, tan 60 is root 3, is 150 by y. Y will be equal to 150 by root 3. Now we are going to put this y here in this equation. So y is 150 by root 3 plus x equal to 150. And we have to find x, so take this here. X equal to, I am taking 150 outside. What do we get? 1 from here and 1 by root 3 from here. So we get 150 root 3 minus 1 by root 3. Multiply root 3 in the numerator and denominator just to eliminate this. So what do we get? 150 root 3 minus 1. And this is root 3, that is 3. So 3 5s are 15. So you get 50. Take root 3 inside. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. And this is minus root 3. So 53 minus root 3 is your distance between these two points. And you can just, as I said, put the value also and find out the decimal form. 1.732 you can use in place of root 3. The angle of elevation of a tower from a point at the same level as the foot of the tower is 30 degrees. On advancing 150 degrees, let me tell you first this thing. The angle of the elevation of this tower AB from a point on the same level as the foot of the tower, so this is the foot at the same level, it is 30 degrees. First is 30 degrees. Now when we advance 150 meters towards the foot, so this is the foot, so we are advancing towards the foot. The angle of elevation of the tower becomes 60 degrees. So this angle becomes 60 degrees. Show that the height of the tower is 129.9. So this h has to be shown as 129.9. So first we'll take triangle ABC. When we take triangle ABC, what do we get? h by x, 1060 is h by x. So 1060 is root 3. So h is root 3x. But we have to eliminate this x. Why? Because we need to find out the height, which has to be 129.9. So x has to be written as h by root 3. This is our first equation. We'll use it somewhere in the next equation. Coming to the triangle A, B and D. This triangle ABD is going to give you tan 30. So tan 30 is perpendicular by base. It will be h by x plus 150. H by x plus 150. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. This is going to be h by x plus 150. Multiply this. X plus 150 is going to be root 3h. This is our second equation. Now x is h by root 3. Let us put it here. It will be h by root 3 plus 150 equal to root 3h. Now bring this here. 150 equal to root 3h minus h by root 3. Take h outside. Root 3 minus 1 by root 3. What do we get? Root 3 is 3, and this is minus 1 by root 3. 3 minus 1 is 2, so 2h by root 3 we have. And here we have 150. So what do we get h as? Root 3 into 150 by 2. So this is 75. So 75 root 3 is there. When you multiply 75 with 1.732, you get exactly 129.9. This is how the answer is going to unfold. So 75 root 3 will be 129.9. The angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a point P for a point A on the ground is 30 degrees. So this is point A, and the angle of elevation of the top of the tower, this tower, is 30 degrees. Moving in a distance of 20 meters, that is, we move 20 meters in the direction of the tower, that is the foot of the tower, heading towards the foot of the tower. At this point B, the angle of elevation now increases to 60 degrees. Find the height of the tower and the distance of the tower from the point A. So we have two triangles now. Here, first triangle is the smaller one with 60 degree angle. The second is the bigger triangle with the angle 30 degrees. So let us take the first one, smaller one. So tan 60. I am taking triangle DCB. This is DCB. Tan 60 is what? H by X. Tan 60 is root 3. And we have to find out the height. So we have to eliminate this X. So I'll write X as H by root 3. First. Now coming to the second triangle, which is DCA or ACD, whichever way you want to write it. Here we have tan 30. And this is going to be perpendicular, that is h by base, x plus 20, that is 20 plus x. Tan 30 is what? 1 by root 3. It is h by 20 plus x. So what do we get? 20 plus x is root 3 h. But x is h by root 3. So 20 plus h by root 3 equal to root 3 h. Bring it here. 20 will be equal to, I am taking h outside. Root 3 minus 1 by root 3, same thing which we have already done. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. I'm writing it here. 3, and this is minus 1 by root 3. So you get 2 by root 3. H into 2 by root 3. Now take this on this side. So H will be equal to 20 into root 3 by 2. That is 2 times 20. You get 10 root 3. H is 10 root 3. This 10 root 3, you can easily. This is only 10 root 3. Right? Let me see. It's H by root 3. Are we missing something? Let me see. It is 2 by root 3. And this is 20 plus h is 10 root 3. That is 1 by root 3. H root 3 is 20 plus h. H we have written as h by root 3. So this is going to be root 3. Root 3 minus 1 by root 3. So it is going to be 3 minus 1 by root 3. 3 minus 1 by 3 minus 1 root 3 minus 1 by root 3. So it will be 10 root 3. So it is going to be 10 root 3. So I just want to change this. It will be 10. Because if you see, this is root 3 minus 1, this is root 3 minus 1 by root 3. 3, this becomes 3, this minus 1, so 2 by root 3, 20 into root 3 by 2, so this is 10. So 10 root 3 is the answer. So we just don't take it, 10 into root 3, root 3 is 1.732, multiplied by 10, it will be 17.32. Now, this is your 17.32, and if one more thing is being asked, that is the height of the tower and the distance of the tower from the point A. So, point A, what is the distance? This is 20. What do we find? X. X, we have to find h by root 3. So, h is, h is root 3x. And x is h by root 3. So, x can be written as h by root 3. And h we found to be 17.23. This is how what is being done here. Actually, it is 10 root 3 by root 3. Right? This is what is being done. This is h by root 3. H is what? 10 root 3, as I said. We found it to be 10 root 3, right? So 10 root 3 by 3, 10 root 3 by root 3. So 10 root 3 root 3 cancels. So now this x, I can write it as 10 root 3 by root 3. This cancels. It is 10. Now what is the distance here? This is 20 and this is what? 10. So 20 plus 10 is the distance from here to here. It is 30. So the height is 17.32 and the distance from C to A is 20 plus x. That is 20 plus 10. That is 30. From the top of a building 15 meter high, the angle of elevation of the top of tower is found to be 30 degrees. From the bottom of the same building, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is found to be 60 degrees. Find the height of the tower and the distance between the building and the tower. So here we have two things, right? First is your 15 meter building. This is 15 meter high and there is a tower. This is a tower. So, the angle of elevation from the top of the building is 30 degrees. This is 30 degrees. And then from the bottom of the same building, this angle of elevation is 60 degrees. We have to find out the height of the tower, that is this hole, and the distance between them. Let me just draw it again. So, we have a building, we have a tower. Let us join the lines. From the top of the tower, the angle of elevation is 30 degrees. From the bottom of the tower, from bottom of the building and top of the building, there are angles. So, from the top of the building, the angle is 30 degrees. From bottom of the building, the angle of elevation to the top of the tower is 60 degrees. And the height of this is 15. So, this will also be 15 from here to here. And let us take it as h from this point to this point. So, we have to find h plus 15, that is the height of the tower, and let us take it as x. So, x and h plus 15 we have to find out. So, let me take the first triangle first. The smaller triangle, this one. So 1060 will be what? 1030, sorry. This h by x. 1030 is 1 by root 3. H by x. So you get x as h root 3. This is our first equation. If you see, it's same thing what I am doing for the beginning. You know, there can be multiple methods to solve it. 1030 is h by x. 1030 is 1 by root 3. So you get x is h root 3. This is first equation. Now coming to the second triangle, which is this one. So 1060. What is 1060? It is h plus 15 by x. So h plus 15 by x. So x is h root 3 and 1060 is root 3. X is what? H root 3. Now bring it here. H root 3 into root 3 is 3h. Is h plus 15. Bring this here, 3h minus h equal to 15. 3h minus h is 2h. 2h is 15. H will be equal to 15 by 2, that is going to be 7.5. So this is 7.5. Now add it to 15 so that you get the height of the tower. So 15 plus 7.5 is going to be 0.5 to 22.5. So the height of the tower is 22.5. How about the distance? See, x is equal to h root 3. So 22.5. into 1.732. That is the distance between them. So let me tell you, this 15 plus 7.5 was the 22.5 which we found out. And when you multiply these two, that is 22.5 and 1.732, you will get the distance of x, that is this distance, right? I hope h root 3. This is h root 3. H is not 22. No, will not take 22.5. Because it is h root 3, h is 7.5. So 7.5 into 1.732 is going to be 12.99. This is going to be the answer. So this is the 12.99. 7.5 into root 3. On a horizontal plane, there is a vertical tower with a flag pole on the top of the tower. At a point 9 meters away from the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation of the top and bottom of the flag pole are 60 degrees and 30 degrees. Find the height of the tower and the flag pole mounted on it. So we have here a vertical tower, AB. Then we have a flag post, that is a pole with a flag. At a point which is 9 meter away from the foot of the tower, that is if you are 9 meter away from here, the angles of elevation of top and bottom are 60 degree and 30 degree. So if you go, if you stand here and look up at the top of the flagstaff, it will be 60 degree. If you look at the bottom of the flagstaff, it will be 30 degree. So why we have to find the height of the tower and the flag pole mounted on it. So we have to find this one and this one. So let us take this as h and this is as x. So first we'll take the smaller triangle, and we know that the distance from here to here is 9. So let us take the smaller one, that is 30 degrees. So ABC triangle I am taking. ABC. So we have tan 30 degrees as h by 9. What is tan 30? It is 1 by root 3. So h is going to be n by root 3. Let it be like this. We are going to solve it. Okay, it's because the solution is already there. So we'll just try multiplying root 3 numerator denominator. So 9 root 3. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. So 3 3 is a 9. So 3 root 3 is your h on the first equation. 3 root 3. Then coming to the second equation, that is 60 degrees. So tan 60. T60 I'm writing. T60 is x plus h, that is whole triangle we are taking DBC. So x plus h by 9. Tan 60 is what? It is root 3. H we found out 3 root 3 by 3. So take this here, 3 root 3 equal to x plus 3 root 3. Now there is something because this is getting cancelled, so we have to relook at this. This is 9 root 3. Now bring it here. 9 root 3 minus 3 root 3 is 6 root 3. So x is 6 root 3. X is 6 root 3. H is your 3 root 3. So this is the height of tower, h, and this is the height of the flagstaff, 6 root 3. So 6 root 3 and 3 root 3, you can use root 3 as 1.732, and you can multiply and get the value in the decimal forms also. A tree breaks down due to storm and the broken parts bend so that the top of the tree touches the ground, making an angle of 30 degrees. The distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground is 8 meter. Find the height of the tree. So here what is happening? There is a tree and it broke from here. It broke from here. And the angle it is making, the you can say head of the tree, when it touches the ground, it is making an angle of 30 degrees. The distance between the foot of the tree to the point where the top touches is 8. From here to here it is 8. Find the height of the tree. So we have to find the height of the tree. If this is say, we don't know either this one or this one. We are not aware of the height. So this is x and this is y. So we'll take x and y and then just add it. We will find x and y. So first thing is, if this is a triangle, this is 30 degrees, this is 90 degrees. So we have this as the perpendicular, this as the base, perpendicular and base. So we can this is hypotenuse, sorry. This is hypotenuse and base. So Pandit Badri Prasad and her bone. So we have to use this base every time. Okay. Base every time. So first time we will take the tan of 30. Tan 30 is x by 8. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. It is x by 8. So you get x as 8 by root 3. This is our first x. Then we have tan. We will not take tan. Perpendicular by base we are already taken. So now we have the hypotenuse and base. Base and hypotenuse comes with cos 60. Cos 30. Cos 30 is base upon hypotenuse. So it is going to be base, that is 8 by hypotenuse y. So y is going to be c. If you take cos 30, it is going to be root 3 by 2. Just take this as root 3 by 2 as 8 by y. What do you get? minus 8 into 2 by root 3. That is 16 by root 3. Now, we have to add this x and y because the tree, this is also y and it broke down and bended like this. So, y plus x is the height of the tree. So, we'll add this x plus y. That is 8 by root 3 plus 16 by root 3. So, this is 19 by root 3. So, when we get this 19 by root 3, 8 and 16 is not 19. What am I doing? 16 plus, this is 24 by root 3. Now, 25 by root 3, multiply root 3 and root 3 in the numerator, denominator, 24 root 3, this will be. And we have root 3 is 3. So, 3 8 is a 24. So, you get 8 root 3. This is 8 root 3 is the answer. Now, this is the next question, question number 20. But we are going to take it in the next discussion. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.